will it be a repeat of the Beijing final? We're about to discover, because the defending Olympic champion Lin Dan is up against the man who finished an agonizing fourth in Beijing, Lee Hyun Il. Won all their matches so far, group matches, although both these men only had one other player in their group, and then through to the knockout stage, last 16 and quarterfinal, and here we are poised at the semi-final stage. Well, of course, Peter, it's in many people's eyes would be a dream final to have a repeat of the previous Olympic final, with the current world and Olympic champion Lin Dan playing against the man who was world number one for so long, Lee Chong Wei. But I suspect this might be a battle royal if it's to transpire that way.
Yes, well, a lot of people will be looking for that rematch, for the two Olympic finalists come together from 2008. But I'm sure Lee Hyun Il, he has other thoughts, and such an experienced player on the circuit, and has come so close before, as you're saying, coming fourth in 2008. And here he comes to the court now.
Yeah, the 32-year-old competing in his third Olympic Games. And so too is this man. Can you believe he was the number one seed at the Athens Olympic Games and lost in the very first round, lost to Ronald Susilo of Singapore 4 years later at the Beijing Games, in front of his adoring home fans. He took gold. For Lee Hyun Il, well, fourth 4 years ago, but yesterday in his quarterfinal encounter, avenged that defeat to beat Chen Jin, who of course beat him in the bronze medal playoff match in Beijing. Lars Rifa of Sweden, our umpire for this match. Lin Dan, 28 years of age, from Fuzhou, capital of Fujian province on the east coast of China. So the battle of the left-handers. And of course, Lin Dan, yesterday in his quarterfinal, had a real battle to overcome another left-hander, number six seed Sho Sasaki of Japan. Went the full distance, an hour and 15 minutes before he came through 21-16 in that deciding game. And as for Lee Hyun Il, well, he's won all of his matches in straight games. 21-15, 21-16, an hour and 1 minute to avenge his defeats from 4 years ago against Chen Jin, number four seed. Hour and 1 minute. But perhaps it's of note that he's obviously feeling the after effects of that match. I'll come back to that in a minute as we look at this man's results so far, including that round of 16 encounter against the Olympic champion from Athens 8 years ago, Indonesian Taufik Hidayat. Now, the reason I was saying that obviously Lee Hyun Il is feeling the after effects of his quarterfinal against the number four seed is because he's wearing those stockings over his calf muscles, and presumably his calf muscles were feeling a little stiff and sore this morning. on those stockings, Peter. Just keep the muscles warm and keep him agile throughout the match.
Yeah, it certainly does, and I think of a lot of players too. It gives them a little bit of confidence if there is a bit of stiffness and soreness around the joints or around the muscles. That, just another added advantage psychologically, if nothing else.
Only thing that occurs to me is obviously he didn't wear those calf supports yesterday, and it's very, very obvious he's got them on today, which presumably gives Lindan a bit of a lift, sort of thinking, well, maybe he's struggling after his quarterfinal encounter.
Possibly, and look, players grab any opportunity to get that sort of psychological advantage even before they get out on the court, so if they tell themselves that he's sore, then it's to an advantage.
Well, plenty of support for Lindan. Lindan's wife and family here at Wembley to watch his Olympic campaign. His wife, of course, Shixing Feng, Olympic silver medalist in the women's singles in Beijing. Well, this incredibly is the 17th meeting between these two men. And of the previous 16, Lindan has won 13 of them. Perhaps more importantly, Peter, the fact Lindan has won the last 8 encounters. And you have to go back 4 years to the final of the Korean Open Super Series event in 2008 for the last time that Lee Hyun Il beat his opponent of today. And there must have been some home advantage, one would have thought, playing at home, home support in Korea.
Yes, definitely would be the case, you would think. But look, a run of 8 games in a row, or matches in a row, where he's beaten him. We were talking about psychological advantages. Well, there's one. Coming out with a 4-love lead in the first game. That would give him a lot of confidence too, Lindan.
Well, this man, Lee Hyun Il, trying to become only the second man to reach an Olympic men's singles final, the first being Son Seung-mo, who is on his coaching bench. Of course, Son, beaten finalist in Athens in 2004, lost out to Taufik Hidayat in that final. There he is. Oh, that's incredible. Looked as if he was going to lift the shuttle. Swayed the body. Checked the racket. And it's an outright winner. Oh, he bides his time, doesn't he? Lindan waits for the right opportunity. And when he strikes, it's lethal.
He certainly has a lot of firepower there.
He's just toying with his opponent at the moment. We're only 5 minutes into the match and he's already 9-1 up.
Certainly is looking a class above, isn't he? Just his speed of movement and the way he gets behind the shuttle.
Oh dear me. 11-1. Mid-game interval. And I can't help but wonder, Peter, whether there's a little bit of a syndrome, not only the fact that physically he had to play very, very hard to beat Chen Jin, but I wonder if once he knew the draw, whether he had built himself up for that revenge match against the Chinese number three player. And psychologically, having done that, he's almost forgotten that, well, you're still in the tournament, got to keep going, there's another match to be played yet. Or do you think he's just been totally outclassed?
Well, he definitely has been totally outclassed in this early stage of the match, but I think you might be right. You know, would have sapped so much energy, not only physically but mentally, and as we saw and we discussed earlier about the calves and the protection he has on them, maybe he's just a little slow out of the blocks because he hasn't prepared for this game like he had the game before.
Yeah. I think one of the difficulties for Lee Hyun Il, as we see Dr. Kang, the president of the International Federation, the BWF, Badminton World Federation, I struggle to understand with his style of play how he's going to win points, because Lee Hyun Il is more of a retriever, isn't he? He's more of a reactor to what opponents do. But when you're playing against somebody who's probably one of the most dynamic attackers in the game and fastest players in the game, just trying to retrieve isn't enough.
No, I think you're right there, Jill. It's and look, it's showing out on the court, isn't it, really? He hasn't got any answers to the court coverage and the power of Lin Dan.
Can a player suddenly in the middle of a match like this play an alien way? Could he or should he start trying to be a little more proactive himself and a little more aggressive in his style?
Oh, you'll have to do something definitely here. He could be, if he started playing the shuttle a lot more flatter and try to move forward into the court, really change up the game, even if it's for 2 or 3 points, just to break that momentum and rhythm of the game, give him some opportunity to get into this first game before it's too late.
Oh, now that's better. Fellow Korean teammates. Of course, both Korea and China have a wonderful tradition in badminton discipline at the Olympic Games. Good rally. But of course, as far as Korea is concerned, men's singles is the only discipline that they haven't won a gold medal in.
Well, they certainly have had a strong tradition in the doubles and mixed doubles. Olympic champions.
Yes, and of course Bang Soo-hyun won the women's singles in Atlanta. Nice to see her at Wembley here in London.
It's lovely play, isn't it? Taking the shuttle nice and high to the net, Lin Dan.
And the Korean just, in my opinion, is not doing anything at the moment to really hurt the defending champion. All sport is about playing to your own strengths and preventing your opponents, all interactive sports, that is, preventing your opponent to playing to their strengths, try and exploit their weaknesses. Problem is, I'm not sure that Lin Dan has any weaknesses, does he?
I'm sure there's some weakness there that you can always find, but no, he's really is the complete package.
No. Well, immediately apologises, asks for the court to be mopped.
Even when you've got him at full stretch, he can still come up with a wonderfully controlled little block, taking the net court at the same time. There's no answer to that shot. Oh, that's super.
Well, that'll maybe lift his spirits a little. Set up with a lovely net shot. Oh. Time and time again. Well, I've been watching Lin Dan for many years now, and I still, when he goes up for that round the head overhead shot, when the shuttle is played down his backhand side, but he still plays it with a forehand action, we call that the round the head shot, and I can't tell whether he's going straight or cross court. Not surprising, opponents left stranded time and time again. It is so deceptive. Well, certainly when the Beijing Olympics had finished, didn't think we'd ever see Lee Hyun Il playing in another Olympics, because he announced his retirement for a third time. He's come back a third time. Very lucky he has, because he's playing some great badminton.
Yes, each of his comebacks have been quite successful, really. He's back into it in like a semi-final of the Olympic Games. It's great position to be in, but he's going to have to work hard here.
Yeah, well, he's beginning to close the gap. He's certainly, it's still a long way to go. At least he's playing himself into form.
Yeah, you just see small glimpses of that change in play that you were talking about earlier. He flattens the shuttle out a little bit more, putting a little bit more speed on it. Oh, not quite across the net though. You had the right idea.
Oh, that's terrific. There we go again with that round the head shot. Game points, 8 of them. So 21-8, 21-12 in 18 minutes of play. The opening game to the defending champion, Lin Dan of China. Well, when Lin Dan came out for this semi-final, looked relaxed, didn't he? Started so well, raced to that 11-1 lead. Oh dear. I think Charles Ranger, is he saying get on top of your opponent, he's looking lethargic, or is he telling Lin Dan that he's looking a little bit laid back? Wish I understood Mandarin.
Well, you would think it'd be the first comment that you made there. His opponent has looked a little bit lethargic, but Lin Dan, he's been just lethal.
Yeah.
With his overheads. He's been hard to stop. And I just thought towards the end of that game, you saw some of the skill and control that Lee Hyun Il has, the ability to play. He started to play some lovely little shots around the front court, some good flat attacking play to the back of the court. But he needs to do that consistently to be able to match Lin Dan.
Just applying the grip powder makes the handle of the racket a little bit tacky, which means that as you try and train grips in between shots, easier to hold on to the racket. So the number two seed, the defending champion Lin Dan of China, having taken that opening game 21-12, will be looking to push home the advantage. And I think it's absolutely imperative that the number seven seed Lee Hyun Il from Korea makes a better start to this second game than he did the first. Lin Dan, of course, rushed to that 11-1 lead.
Yes, he certainly cannot afford to give him such a big lead as he did in the first game. And he's taken the first 2 points, Lin Dan.
I remember when this man won his first major medal, which was a silver at the 2002 Asian Games in Busan in his home country. He's medaled in world championships. That agonizing fourth position at the last Olympics. 13 titles he's won throughout his career. But in a way, Peter, he's always been the nearly man of world badminton, hasn't he? I remember when he lost in the final of the All England Championships back in 2006. Lost out to his opponent of today in that final.
Yes, he's always been thereabouts, but you know, a consistent player, but just not making the big games.
Mind you, we are being hypercritical, aren't we? Because I mean, to medal in world championships, Asian Games, All England's.
The depth of opposition that he's had to come up against over those number of years as well. She's definitely off to a much better start in this second game. Lee Hyun Il.
There's his wife in the blue t-shirt there. Lin Dan's wife, of course. Control at the front of the court is just exquisite. The game plan from Lee Hyun Il is just to try and extend the rallies, wear down his opponents. There's a little bit of sting of the defending champion, appears to have deserted him at the moment here in the second.
Few points you've seen Lee Hyun Il, he's been quite effective in turning Lin Dan around on the backhand side too, and then stepping forward and controlling a number of the rallies.
Well, he doesn't miss many of those, I can assure you. A rare error from Lin Dan.
Yes, a real let off for Lee Hyun Il.
Oh, well, all set up once again with the tight spinning net shot. That was the one that did the damage. Forced the shorter lift. And then the opportunity to play the winner. Points towards the line as he turns to his coaches as if to say, needed I have played that? Was it going out?
I suppose in that case it's safer to play the shuttle. He's done all the hard work in setting up the point.
Xi Xingfang, well, she looks quite nervous in the crowd there, doesn't she? Lin Dan's wife.
Thank you.
Oh, yes. Oh, this is really what we were talking about in the opening game, isn't it, Peter? Taking more initiative, be more aggressive in his style, more attacking shots. But of course, it is physically more demanding to play that way.
Certainly, isn't it? And it's as if he's playing a very patient game in his second game. He has definitely controlled the front court a lot more, Lee Hyun Il, but he's not rushing his shots at all. He's not panicking.
Oh, that's right in the corner. Well, we've talked about the physicality of Lee Hyun Il with his victory over the number four seed Chen Jin in his quarterfinal. Let's not forget that Lin Dan also had a marathon match against number six seed Sho Sasaki from Japan, an hour and 15 minutes before he came through that encounter, 21-16 in the decider.
Nice play, isn't it? Really well orchestrated rally. Playing to the back of the court, getting the short lift. He's playing a very precise game, Lee Hyun Il. He certainly hasn't got the venom and power of Lin Dan, but he's got great placement around the court.
Unfortunately, has to go down as an unforced error. So too does that.
It doesn't help his cause at all, does it, really?
Not at all. And a 3-point advantage to Lin Dan at the mid-game interval here in the second. It's very interesting to me that Lin Dan initiating the conversation there, obviously telling his coaches what he thinks before they tell him what they think.
Well, he's got a very strong personality, and that's part of his persona and the way he plays on court as well.
Yeah, he's great for the sport, isn't he? His character. Huge, huge star in China. A couple of years ago was the male sports person of the year, voted the most valuable player of the entire Asian Games across all sports.
So that's 3 points in a row, just unforced errors, and you wonder where the fitness is coming into it a little bit, because he had that really long rally just prior to that. He was successful, won the point. That's whether he can maintain that quality of play.
Skill to play that tight spinning net shot, but when your opponent is standing at the net as Lee Hyun Il was, the courage to play that. Just easing out a gap here, Lin Dan. And Lee Hyun Il will have to be awfully careful here. 5 points the difference between these two men at the moment.
That's a good straight smash, straight down the line.
Yes, it wasn't full power, but the placement was excellent. Now he's opened up a 6-point cushion.
Just seems to have that little bit of extra pace and speed, doesn't he, Lin Dan? And Lee Hyun Il just struggling to cope with that speed.
Seven of the last 8 points have gone to Lin Dan. And it's interesting because it was at 8-9 and he just thought Lee Hyun Il was beginning to mount his comeback and beginning to be a real threat to the defending champion. And sensing the pressure, what does Dan do? Just ups his pace, ups his intensity and pulls away. Sign of a great champion. Time is running out as far as Lee Hyun Il is concerned. Well, it's been a masterclass, quite frankly, so far by Lin Dan. Points away from making it a repeat final of the Olympic Games from 4 years ago. The dream final as far as all badminton fans are concerned. Well, this is remarkable. 11 of the last 13 points. Twelve of 14 points to close out the match. 21-12, 21-10. The margin of victory for the defending champion, Lin Dan of China. The Chinese fans here at Wembley celebrate. And the defending Olympic champion, defending in style so far, through to the final once more. Well, it was a real shame in the end, because I thought at 9-8 in the second game, I thought Lee Hyun Il really had possibilities to win this semi-final. This the final rally. Very fitting that it was an excellent, accurate smash from Lin Dan that closed it out. A little wave to his fans. And we will have an Olympic final. The number one and two seeds, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia against the defending champion, Lin Dan of China. Their confirmation of the semi-final score, 21-12, 21-10 in 39 minutes of play.